In this example, we are given that the shell of a space station is a blackened sphere in which a temperature of 500 Kelvin is maintained due to operation of appliances of the station. We are required to find the temperature of shell if the station is enveloped by a thin spherical black screen of nearly the same radius as that of shell. Now, in this particular situation, we are given that say there is a spherical space station and say it is of radius r and its temperature T is maintained by operation of appliances. So, we can say as the temperature is maintained, so whichever amount of power is generated, the same amount must be radiated to the space also, then only the temperature can be maintained. If there is imbalance in the radiated power and generated power, obviously the temperature will change. So, in this situation, we can write as T is maintained, we can state radiation power must be equal to generated power. So, in this situation, we can directly write the generated power to be sigma T to power 4 into 4 pi r square, which is sigma A T to power 4. As it is already given that the sphere is black, we can take its emissivity to be 1. So, total generated power can be written as sigma A T to power 4. Now, if this space station is enveloped by a thin spherical shell, then obviously the shell will receive power from the sphere and radiate to the surrounding. So, again, as we know that the generated power is same, so generated power must be equal to sigma T to power 4 into 4 pi r square. And for the shell, we can state, now the shell temperature should be equal to T and the space station temperature should change to T1. So, we can simply state again generated power is equals to the radiated power. So, net radiated power can be directly given as sigma into 4 pi r square multiplied by, if we talk about the space station, we can state it will be radiating power as proportional to T1 to power 4 and absorb power from the envelope as sigma A T to power 4. So, this must be given as T1 to power 4 minus T2 power 4. And as generated power will remain same, if we substitute the value, it will be sigma T to power 4 into 4 pi r square is equals to sigma into 4 pi r square T1 to power 4 minus T2 power 4. As sigma and 4 pi r square gets cancelled out, on analyzing we'll get 2 T to power 4 is equals to T1 to power 4. This implies the new temperature of a space station can be given by taking 4th root of this expression, which is 2 to power 1 by 4 multiplied by the initial temperature, which is 2 to power 1 by 4 multiplied by 500 Kelvin. So, on analyzing, this will be 595 Kelvin. That will be the answer to our problem.